throne. The last paragraph of the story is, I don't know, a couple lines up from the bottom. Because the king had done all this with wisdom, so that no man would understand till the wise man who could understand their proper order came. So the original king, like, sort of disordered his kingdom in order for someone to come along and know how to put all these different objects back in place. And says, and the lion that stood at the place from which the road extends should be placed here, etc. And he ordered them all put in the right order, to take the rose from the bottom and insert it at the top, and to put all the other things in proper order. In the actual tale, it says that he should, the table needs to be placed a little bit over to this side, and the menorah needs to be placed a little bit over to this side, and the birds need to be placed over to this side, and the animals need to be placed over to this side. And so he's going around and he's rearranging all of these metal and wooden figures in the kingdom. And once they're put into their proper place, that's when the kingdom sort of goes up in song. And I think that I would conclude by saying something about this entire process enabled him to understand that being king isn't dominating anything or controlling anything. It's actually deeply sensing what the song in each little aspect of reality is calling out for, and knowing how to help it find its right place inside of a community.
And that's exactly what he says. At first, when you come into the garden, there's all these paths, but nobody can figure out the relationship of the paths to the throne.
Yeah.
Once everything's fixed, everything has its own path.
Yeah. And I just, my last point is, I guess it's a little bit more meta, because his final comment in the Yiddish is about how, I feel like since all of these things are made out of the same substance as the ark that you hold over the different animals. Let me see how I can say this in the least complicated way possible. So he says the point is misado to zayin it lechazach. It's to put into arrangement every sort of thing. Basically, like, I kind of want to read this as a little bit about not only sort of how we treat people in the world and how we understand people in our communities, but also how we read text and how we read Torah. And there are these symbols, there are these vessels that we pour our longings into. And something about how meaning is shifting, and we can only really understand what a symbol means when we pour ourselves into it, when we pour our yearnings into it and hear what those yearnings sound like echoed back. It's something about how symbols are so contingent on the way we interact with them, and how meaning is so much contingent on how we interact with it. There's no set meaning. The king's palace that says there are set boundaries and set walls and like a real kingdom that is fixed and in place needs to be left so we can return to it and figure out what it actually means for ourselves.
I don't know if you know about Rabbi Nachman's throne. Rabbi Nachman had his disciples, when he was in Breslov, made him a beautiful carved chair with all kinds of animals and birds and so on the chair. And it was kept in Breslov, it was kept in where the Hasidim lived in Russia for many, many years. In the 1930s, there were very few Breslovers left. There were a lot of trouble. The main Breslov community that was going to survive was in Eretz Yisrael, and they took apart the chair and shipped it secretly to Jerusalem piece by piece and it was reassembled in Jerusalem. When I first went to Breslov in Jerusalem, the main Breslov synagogue was at the end of Mea Shearim Street. There was this beautiful wooden chair on the bima, and there was a little sign on it that said, I remember, word, Zeh HaKisei Shel Rabbeinu Zal Ve'Az Hara Gedola Mireshem Alav. This is the chair, this is the throne of our master of blessed memory. You are severely warned not to sit on it. And the original hardback edition of my tormented master had a photograph of the chair on the cover. I'll try to bring one in next week if I can remember. Unfortunately, some American kid who had become a Baal Teshuva to Breslov who had studied woodworking was allowed to refinish the chair. He flipped the chair and he didn't refinish it. And he refinished it and it came out all very shiny and new looking. And then they thought it was something valuable, so they put it in a glass case, and it's now in a glass case, like, if you remember the Avdil. Yes, Eichmann in the glass case. It's a square box like that on the Biba, and it's just, you know, it's just they ruined it. But it's a very special treasure of Breslov. And somehow, this throne and this story and that throne of Rabbi Nachman himself somehow go together in my mind. See you next week for our last session of the Master of Prayer. That's quite a wild story. Hope you can all make it. Thank you all. Really, really beautiful reading. Really, very, very nice piece of work. We've learned to do this very well collectively. Yeah, Mark, you have the hardback, I see, but no longer the desk jacket.
It's
right?
After you have the read, of course, now, so now they're coming in from the side.
Yes.
I took the last sentence from Zohar. Basically, this is his autobiography. He's in two parts of himself. Isn't he saying, I am the Messiah? That's how I read the last sentence. The last sentence comes out of nowhere.
This is the last sentence is now.
Why was that chapter? You know? Right. I saw this as his autobiography. He brought together two sides himself. And he reasoned to live in the world.
Yeah, I'm sorry you didn't say that. What everybody was saying, we would have got back to that. I've forgotten I assigned that chapter. The multiple levels of every one of these stories can be about not being the Messiah. It happens.
Well, that's how
it's a task of everyone. Yeah. Every one of the stories.
Thank you so much. I won't be here.
Okay.
I'm so good to meet you.
Very nice. Very nice to have you here. Thank you for being here. And hope you enjoy it. It is very helpful, yes, always. That's why I keep doing it.
But they had to have it.
I'm